The 1960s wasn't just a decade. It was a state of mind. While a professor urged a generation to tune in, turn on, and drop out, a rebel dodged the CIA, and baby boomers got a little twisted. Events that changed the world, songs that stirred our souls. It's Back to the 60s right now on History Rocks. Back in 1943, Swiss scientist Dr. Albert Hofmann made a very trippy breakthrough. He discovered that a chemical within ergot, a mold that grows on grain, produced feelings of dizziness, anxiety, visual distortion, and the desire to laugh. What Hofmann had discovered was lysergic acid diethylamide, LSD. Since his discovery, researchers, doctors, even the CIA had been trying to figure out what to do with this hallucinogenic chemical. Then, in the 1960s, a Harvard psychologist, Dr. Timothy Francis Leary, seemed to discover exactly what LSD was good for.
For the 5 hours after I ate these mushrooms, I learned more about psychology than I had in the preceding 16 years as a psychologist.
In a white room with black curtains, near the station. Black roof country, no gold payments, tired starlings. Silver horses ran down moonbeams in your dark.
LSD can produce the greatest ecstasy that man's known, the ecstasy of revelation, seeing that there's more.
My contentment. I'll wait in this place where the sun never shines. Wait in this place.
Where are you?
Oh, stop that, man.
Where
stop
are
that.
You, man?
Stop
You're
that. Not
You said no strings could secure you at the station. Platform ticket, restless diesels, goodbye windows.
Man, LSD is like a vitamin for the brain. I mean, to expand your mind.
Station.
Smart aleck, Harvard professor, bourbon-drinking atheist, intellectual, before I took LSD. Now I'm God intoxicated.
At the party, she was kindness in the hard crowd. Just press.
LSD is here. And what are we going to do about it? Should we pass a law against fire and say only doctors can have fire? Should we pass a law against LSD and say only doctors can take this trip to divine process, go out of their minds, use this inner microscope? Of course we can't, because it's here and it's going to be used.
The juvenile, random, frivolous taking of LSD in a party setting without supervision is dangerous and is doing a good deal of harm.
Leary fled the country, but was eventually captured and returned to prison in January 1973 and served 3 years. Several years after his release, he would once again come face to face with G. Gordon Liddy, but this time as a friend and partner on a lecture tour. In 1959, Fidel Castro, commanding 800 guerrilla fighters, took control of Cuba. Castro then proceeded to seize property and businesses, much of which belonged to major U.S. companies. Unhappy with Castro's real estate ventures, not to mention his communist leanings, the CIA vowed to get rid of him by any means necessary, and by some means that seemed entirely unnecessary.
Pushes past police and security guards despite rumors of assassination plots against him.
I'm not feeling that good myself. The boy you shot at me, the warm bad rat. And even now I said, and I wonder why. That when I think of you, I stop myself to cry. I just can't waste my time. Stop believing the boy lies.
Castro leaflets are scattered over the city by a plane based in the United States.
Coming up, why was the Soviet Empire so excited about a dog? And later, find out how the Super Bowl got its name. Here's a hint, it doesn't have anything to do with football. In the 1960s, outer space was the ultimate frontier of the Cold War. The Soviets had gotten there first by launching Sputnik in 57. The beeping radio signals that the satellite sent back captivated the American public and spawned hundreds of Sputnik fads, satellite-shaped lighting fixtures, space-age fashion, and a variety of Sputnik cocktails, all made from vodka. But the U.S. government, humiliated by the Soviet achievement, stepped up their own otherworldly pursuits. The space race was about to blast off and take the whole world on a magic carpet ride.
Recent reports indicate the Reds are pressing their man in space program at least as vigorously as America.
This nation should commit itself to achieving the goal before this decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth.
The assassination of JFK launched the nation into a state of mourning, but it also fostered speculations into an all-consuming search for answers. The government's official explanation came less than a year later from the Warren Commission, headed by Supreme Court Chief Justice Earl Warren. Their conclusion? That three bullets were fired, all by Oswald, and that two hit Kennedy, one killing him. They also concluded that Oswald had come up with the assassination plot and carried it out all by himself. But many Americans just couldn't believe this. What followed were wild speculations and theories put forth by a strange assembly of characters, some compelling, some crackpot, all believing they could see something that others couldn't.
Smile, because all the while I
Despite the many outlandish theories on Kennedy's assassination, in 1976, Congress felt there were enough legitimate questions about the Warren Report to prompt a reinvestigation. The conclusion this time, there likely was a conspiracy. What the conspiracy was, they didn't say. Coming up, why is Ralph Nader bumming out these hippies? And later, how could America stay angry at a face like this?
I am the greatest.
The place, the desert. The year, 2270. Who knows? 300 years from now, someone may find a Volkswagen still running.
Thanks.
German automaker Volkswagen had a tough time selling its cars to Americans in the 1950s. VW had two U.S. models at the time, the Type 1, dubbed the Bug, and the Type 2, which they called a station wagon. Odd-looking and slow, both were polar opposites of the tail-fin powerhouses that Detroit was cranking out, and it didn't help that VW owed its start to the Third Reich. But in 1959, Volkswagen decided to take on the American market in a new way. They hired ad man Bill Birnbach, best known for humorous ads selling Levy's Jewish rye. The campaign Birnbach proposed was revolutionary. The question was, would America get it?
Every day at Volkswagen for the past 25 years, we've been testing and torturing things like door hinges and hood locks, seats, and shock absorbers. And for all these years of testing and improving the Volkswagen, we ask a mere 1780. Never before has a car gone through so much for so little.
Cars in the world, so there's more than enough headroom, even for the little woman.
It got me on a mountain top, was burning like a silver flame. The summit of beauty and love, and Venus was her name. She's got.
Stop wondering.
Wow! She's got it!
Oh,
Volkswagen introduced a new Beetle in 1998. This time around, it got high marks for safety from both the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety and the National Highway Safety Administration. Coming up, who knew a name change could cause so much trouble? And later, how many pizzas does one soldier have to eat to get a date in Bangkok? But first, which one of these four bands has not been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? The Who, Sly and the Family Stone, Steppenwolf, or Cream? The answer when History Rocks returns. Before the break, we asked which one of these four bands has not been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The answer? Steppenwolf. As the decade began, a brash young boxer exploded onto the scene by winning the gold medal in the 1960 Rome Olympics. Cassius Clay, the hard-hitting, fast-talking fighter from Louisville, Kentucky, was ready to take the boxing world by storm. But his gold medal didn't shield him from the racism he encountered when he returned home. A frustrated Cassius Clay hurled his medal into the Ohio River and thus began years of personal battles outside the ring.
This will be no contest. This will be a total annihilation.
36 years after he sent his Olympic gold medal to the bottom of the Ohio River, Muhammad Ali was honored at the 1996 Summer Olympic Games in Atlanta and given a replacement medal. After World War II, people started having babies, and lots of them. Those born between 1946 and 1964, some 80 million, are known as baby boomers. Toy companies seized upon this huge potential market. Mattel, for one, saw their profits rise from $18.3 million in 1960 to a staggering $211 million only 9 years later. It was a creative period in the toy industry, leaving us with many of the classic toys and games kids still play with today.
Weeballs wobble, but they don't fall down.
Go to the head of the class.
Command the Zeroids from Ideal.
Etch-a-Sketch, the toy you'll never tire of.
You'll love it, and so will your youngster.
Sunshine came softly through my window today. Could have tripped out easy, but I've changed my way. It'll take time, I know.
Funny bone.
play faster.
They're the fastest metal cars you've ever seen. But now's new Hot Wheels.
Not on a rainbow, so you can.
This Christmas, it's the Big Wheel by Marks.
When you've made your mind up forever to be mine, I'll pick up your hand and slowly blow your little mind. When you've made your mind up forever to be mine.
You said there is no reason.
Coming up, confessions from soldiers in country. Courtesy of the U.S. Post Office. More than 3 million American mothers and fathers saw their sons leave to fight in Vietnam. Some parents were proud, some were angry, but they were all scared. The letters that the soldiers sent back home paint a portrait of innocence lost, hearts yearning for home, and most of all, the terrible cost of war.
Okay, let's go.
Wait.
58,000 soldiers lost their lives in Vietnam, but the families and friends who survive still write to their boys. Since it opened in 1982, more than 50,000 letters and gifts have been left at the Vietnam War Memorial. So, what's happened since the 60s? Muhammad Ali handed his boxing gloves over to daughter Layla, who in her ring debut knocked out her opponent in the first round. In later years, Timothy Leary would shift his focus from the exploration of the mind to the exploration of space. So it's only fitting that after his death on May 31st, 1996, Leary's ashes were launched into space, where he now trips the